Welcome to the SharePoint PnP Page Transformation webcast. My name is Bert Janssen. I'm a Senior Service Engineer inside the SharePoint and OneDrive organization. The topic of this webcast is transforming publishing pages that use a custom page layout. So in this series, in the previous webcast talked about like a basic publishing page using an out-of-the-box page layout. Now, in real life, customers have custom page layouts, more complex things. So how do you handle that during page transformation? Page transformation is typically used using PnP PowerShell. So if you go to akit.ms/svpnp-powershell, you will find the needed instructions to set up PnP PowerShell, either using install-module commandlets or using the MSI approach. Both work, both get you like a nice working PnP PowerShell setup. Now, before diving into the demo, a little recap. So this slide was explained in detail in the previous webcast where we did introduction to publishing page transformation. But I wanted to kind of recap here is that in this webcast, we are focusing on using a custom mapping for your page layout. So you will have a look at a custom page layout mapping model. How does it look and how can you generate it? With that being said, let's actually immediately jump into a demo. So I'm going to go to my my site. And let's first have a look at the actual source page that we are going to transform. This is the page, and I'm going to put the page in edit mode. And like other publishing pages, it has fields like a page image field, article date, byline field. It has like a content area, a rich content area, where there's some formatted text. It has a roll-up image. In this case, you notice there's also like a piece of text, which is, I can't change it. It's a fixed piece of content, which is created by adding a particular content editor web part as a fixed web part in the page layout used for this page. Furthermore, you see that this page has a web part zone, and that's because the page layout that's driving this page has a custom web part zone defined in it. And in here, we actually added a basic list web part showing data from a documents library. What else is special about this page is actually the metadata. If I go to the metadata and load it, then you'll see that this page also has let me scroll down a little bit. It also has here summary links defined. So summary links is a standard field, which in this case has been configured for this particular field. The summary links is not on the page visible, but it is actually part of the page metadata. And to wrap up, this page also has a custom drone category field, which is a managed metadata field, having a D88 tag defined. So that's the page. Let's have a look at our destination. So remember, page transformation for publishing pages always goes cross-site. So in our case, in our demo, we have a communication site named page transformation demo target that will be the target site collection to host the page. If you go over here to the pages library, everything is nice, clean, and empty. Now, I'll first do the actual transformation, and then later on, I'll kind of explain a bit more about what happened under the covers of the transformation engine. As usual, first step is connecting PnP PowerShell to the site that you want to use. So I'm doing that. My user is this one, and my password. And then we are connected. The next step is doing the actual page transformation. We use the convert to -PnP client side page commandlet like any other page transformations we've done before. In this case, we are doing the D88_specs page. It's a publishing page. We specify the target web URL because that's a mandatory parameter when you transform publishing pages. What's kind of different here now is that we have this page layout mapping defined. So this points to a a contoso mapping XML file that we'll kind of discuss in a second after the transformation is done. When I hit enter, the actual transformation works, but this time the transformation is using the information defined in our page layout mapping model, so which actually is this contoso mapping.xml file. Now, while this is running, we can already switch to the site and see what comes out. So the page is already created over here, but before we do it, let's go to site contents, go to the site assets, and let's see if also the page assets are being correctly copied over. And that seems to be the case. We have the 88 assets, so we have different images showing up here, and then we have the header image showing up in a separate folder. That all looks good, so let's go back to the pages library and let's open up our D88 page. And here we have a fairly nice looking publishing page, a modern client-side page created from a publishing page, which is, where was it? Let's go back to the publishing page that we had. So you guys can compare the before and the after. It's always fun to compare before and after. So this is the before, the 88. So scrolling down a little bit so you see what we had. And now we have this. So all looks quite the same content as there, just looks nicer. If you look very careful, you see that there is this these things over here. They're popping up. And what is that actually? So let's put the page in edit mode so it gets a bit more easier to see. Actually, this is the quick links. Remember that we had summary links as a field in the original page. And for now, here we have defined that we want to have summary links as a web part on the page. Summary links becomes quick links. And this is the result. Maybe it's nicer now, like let's say you want to finalize this page, you could say like put this in a film strip mode and then you get like nice bigger pictures for your quick links. So this looks better. But for the rest, this is like a modern publishing page. Looking at the page details, we also see that we had metadata. Remember that we had a term defined for this source page, the drone type. What you see here is that the same metadata has been configured for the target page. So if the target library has the correct fields available, then meaning we can just copy over the metadata from the source to the target, what has happened in this demo. But I'm happy with this page, so I'm going to hit publish and then this page becomes available for my users. Alrighty, so now the page is done. Now what happened kind of under the covers? For that, I think there's two things to show. First of all, there is the custom page layout that we used. So this custom page layout has two things which are kind of important to understand. So first of all, it has a custom web part zone. So that's what you saw when we edited the page. There's this particular zone in the page layout enables end users to add web parts to this pages created on the, based upon the page layout. And furthermore, there was a hard-coded web part on the page layout, a content editor web part containing some HTML content. This content was actually the text with the few images in the middle of the page. Now, this is what we have as a page layout. Now, to drive the transformation, we have a contoso mapping, a page layout mapping, which is kind of generated of this page layout. Now, here you see like a cleaned up version, but if you have to start, actually what you can do is you can call an export PHP client-side page mapping, and you specify custom page layout mapping. And at that point, this command will analyze all the mappings inside your publishing portal and generate one XML file containing all the mappings. What you then do next is copy your custom mappings, or actually drop all the out-of-the-box mappings from that file, only leave your custom mappings in there and clean them up. Now, to clean them up, what are typical things that you do? So there's a number of things actually. Let's kind of cover them one by one. First of all, there is the page layout. So you often want to assign a content type. So if you use modern site page content types, you can perfectly assign your content type over here. Second thing that is a common thing to do is configuring the header. Now, I think the default page header mapping, what you see over here, is fairly good because it takes the rollup image to be the page header image. It takes the article byline to be the page topic header, and will take the publishing contact as being the authors to show on the page header. So in most cases, this is fine, but you obviously you can change it if you want. Next step is metadata, like which of the fields of the old publishing page will become metadata on the modern target page. In this case, we have in our source page a field called drone category, which is taxonomy field. And that content will be copied over to another taxonomy field on the modern site page content type called drone types. You can add additional fields where you just say source field goes to this particular target field. The fields have to exist in the current version of the page transformation, so you have to create the target fields. But once the fields are there, you can simply define the mapping over here and you're good to go. When it comes to content on the page, you have to define all the elements that will be visible as page content. Obvious ones are the page image. So if there's a page image, you want to show it again. And that's why we map the page image to a wiki image part. And we take over content from this field to become properties of the wiki image part. So being the image URL and alternative text properties. To do so, we use a custom function called toImageURL, which essentially kind of cleans up the provided input, so we have a nice server-relative image URL. Furthermore, the page content typically is rich text content that you want to use, and this becomes wiki text. So in this case, simply we just take over everything in here and treat it as wiki text. The summary links field, it was there as well. It was only in the metadata and the source page, but we wanted to show it on the page here. So we take the summary links field and generate it as a summary links web part, where we just copy over the content, essentially do the transformation. So default transformation for summary links will be quick links, and that's what you saw actually in the output. If there's other fields that you want to show up as content, you simply add them over here. Then you have the web part zones. So your page can have multiple web part zones. You simply define them over here with a particular row and column. Actually, so you see row and column appearing for any visual piece of content. So the fields which become page content have row and column, the same for the web part zones, and the same for the fixed web parts. And based upon this row and column, we kind of automatically detect the layout that's needed. So each row will become like a section, and depending on the number of columns, the section will get one, two, or three columns. So going here at the bottom, the final thing that we have is this fixed web part. Remember that we had that content editor web part on the page, in the page layout, to be more precise. That content editor web part is defined here as well as a web part, and the properties of that content editor web part are defined here. So the main thing is the content property, which contains the same content as the actual web part when it was in the page layout. During transformation, we'll see this is actual web part and kind of do the transformation. In this case, content editor web part goes to HTML text. So that's what you saw as a result. So the key thing here is when you are modernizing your classic publishing portal is to build these page layout mapping files for actually one mapping file containing multiple page layouts. So you can have multiple of these, have one page layout element here per page layout and configure it so that it gets you the right end result. All right, it was a slightly longer demo, but I think it's worthwhile to really do a deep dive in how these things work. Let's flip back to slides to wrap up this session. Just a giving us some additional resources. So all of this is documented under ak.ms/svpnp-page-transformation. To find PowerShell, you use ak.ms/svpnp-powershell, and this is all open source, so which means it lives in a GitHub repository in the SharePoint organization. The repo name is sp-dev-modernization, and besides the source code, it also contains an issue list. So if you use page transformation, if you bump into something, if you have a question, if you have a change request, please log all of these issues and requests in the issue list so we can track them and build a better page transformation going forward.